Welcome everybody to today's lecture. For those who don't know me yet, my name is Daniela Gottschlich. I'm a political scientist and professor for sustainability and social design, Gesellschaftsgestaltung. And together with my colleague Lars Hochmann, we started the project Abpflastern. Most of you know that the Abpflastern project was inspired by the Dutch Tegel Wippen. One of the masterminds behind the National Tegel Wippen Contest is Frank Lee Creative Director Eva Braxma. We are very happy to welcome you, Eva, as a speaker at our lectures today. Unfortunately, your announced colleague Remo is not able to attend, so we are all the more pleased that you will give us a first-hand presentation of what Tegel Wippen is all about. After the presentation, you all have the opportunity to ask questions, whether in English or in German, so we help each other to translate the question if there are problems. So, Eva, welcome. Thank you that you are here, and the floor is yours.
Thank you so much. Thank you for having me. Yeah, my colleague was supposed to do it, but I'm here. You might hear a screaming baby at some point, but yeah, I can't help that. Let's just say that's the fun or something of presenting at home. Yeah, perfect. All right. Yeah, so we are creative agency, Frankly. My name is Eva. My colleague's name is Remco. We are a small agency, and we're the two of us. We also work with a couple of freelancers, of course, but we are small and very quick normally. Let me see. Yeah. So what do we do next to the NK Tegelwippen? Two examples of projects that we've done is the rain bar, which you see on the left here. This is the only bar where it rains inside. This bar travels from festival to festival, and people put on a raincoat, they get into the bar, and it starts to rain. And while they hear thunder and see lightning, a voice tells them that it rains more and more in the Netherlands. And if we do nothing, there will be water everywhere. At the end, you also drink a beer made of rainwater. And we start a conversation about climate adaptation and what you can do around the house to adjust to the changing climate. Also, we organize a rooftop event. It's called Roof. And with an event filled with music and views over the city and workshops and more, we start a conversation about rooftops and how we can use them. There's a whole city on top of our city, which is Amsterdam. And we could use this as a public space or to grow food or plants. Or to generate energy. And basically what we do always is tell kind of difficult stories in a positive and light way. And another project is, of course, the NK Tegelwippen, which means Dutch Championships of Tile Flipping, Tile Lifting. It's a contest where we depave the Netherlands together. Yeah, it's really important to unseal surfaces. You probably already know this, but our country, as well as yours, is experiencing more extreme weather. Heavy rains and long periods of drought and heat are becoming more common, and more greenery ensures that we can handle this a little bit better. So the idea for the NK Tegelwippen started in 2020 as an alternative for football. As you might remember, COVID-19 hit in 2020. So there were no football games, no games at all, actually, where we could go to. And everybody was in their house and in their garden. So it was actually the perfect time to go and work in your garden. Here you see the two cities that we started with in 2020. We just started as a pilot version with Amsterdam versus Rotterdam. And these are actual rivals in football and in other things. So we actually used this rivalry to yeah to green the city, and these are the aldermen from Amsterdam and Rotterdam, and they were very concerned with the competition, and they actually lifted the first tiles, and they did a lot on social media as well. Since 2020, the competition has grown. This year, 199 municipalities competed against each other. And of course, it's about who lifts the most tiles and wins the prizes. So it starts in March, and it lasts until October. So we just finished actually, in October. And we just announced the winners last week. So it's 7 months of tiles lifting, and we hope to get a little bit of a greener Netherlands. How it works is everybody can participate. Of course, we encourage municipalities to unseal public spaces as much as possible, but we focus our communication on residents to unseal their own gardens. So how it works is people go to our website, they remove tiles in their garden and submit them to our website. They fill out a form with their name, their email address, the city they live in, and the amount of tiles, and of course a proof picture, because we want to check if it's true that they lifted these tiles, because we check if the amount of tiles matches the photo. And of course, these tiles are added up to the city that you live in, and also to the tile pile, which is called the tegelteller in Dutch. Maybe that translates a little bit to German, I'm not sure. That's how we basically tell who the winner is, and also how many tiles are lifted in the whole year. In total, there are now over 14 million removed tiles during our competition. Last year, there were 5.5 million tiles removed, and a total of 14 is about 260 soccer fields. So if you can imagine that, it's quite a lot. Of course, it's an awareness campaign, so it's mostly that we just tell people what they can do in their garden for a little bit of climate adaptation, still 14 million is quite a lot. But it's a competition, so we need prizes, and we have a lot of prizes, because we divided the municipalities in three rankings. So we have a big, medium, and small municipalities. All these win on the basis of TPI, which is tiles per inhabitant. And they win a golden shovel, very prestigious. And the city that lifts the most tiles in total wins the golden tile. They're very happy with it, as you can see on these pictures. But we also have the whipper of the month. So from these photos that we receive every day, we select the best ones, and our jury chooses which one wins the whipper of the month. So every month there is a whipper who wins a very, very nice package of prizes. And at the end, there is an audience award, which you see in the middle on the bottom. And they win a really cool golden award as well. A couple of figures. We have 12,500 visitors on our website every month. There's over 800 entries every month. So the entries that I just told you about, the pictures that we receive, and about 8,000 social media followers. And it's really cool. We have daily media attention during the campaign, like from really local, like my city lifted these many tiles or is in front or stuff like that. But also really the main media in the Netherlands. And also, yeah, we were on TV in Germany, also on the BBC. There was an article in The Guardian And I was on the Australian radio, which was really funny. So yeah, we're hoping to have a European championship maybe soon. You guys are already working on it, so maybe that would be cool. Yeah, another thing is really cool is the fan content. So of course we organize the competition, but everybody takes their own, does their own take on it. There were a lot of songs about the Tegelwippe. There was an alderman that had a rap, who was rapping to its inhabitants, that they should lift a lot of tiles. There were Tegelwip themed floats on several carnival parades, and we saw a lot of fun things. There was a Tegelwip coach in a city that had actual really funny content on social media as well. So it's nice that that everybody has their own take on it. Yeah, so as I said, we organize the competition and we make sure there's counting and there's rankings. The municipalities also do a lot. So they have their own communication and they tell their own inhabitants what they should do, remove tiles, and they help them as well. So a nice example is the tile taxis, which basically is a big truck that picks up the tiles for free because tiles can be quite heavy. So you don't have to bring them to a specific place, but they can be picked up for free, and that's really cool. That's been growing since the competition. It started in Amsterdam in 2020 as well, the first tile taxi, and now I think it's in around 30 or 50 municipalities that do this. So that's really nice to see. And also a really cool example is the football grass promotion. This started in Arnhem and is also carried out in Rotterdam. And basically the grass in a football field, in a soccer field, is replaced every couple of years. And people that go to these games, of course, really want a piece of this grass. So what they did is they made sure you could win a piece of grass if you turned in a tile in return. So that's really fun because you see that there's another target group targeted. So football fans are normally not really people that are concerned with climate adaptation. And this is a new target group that is addressed by this. And they put in a little bit of grass in their garden and maybe not really to add to the climate adaptation, but they secretly do it. So that's really nice. Then there's also a really cool promotion that they do in a lot of cities, which is that you can swap your tile for a plant. So you come to a place that you can swap your tile, that you can turn your tile in, and then you get a plant for free. We've also seen a tile flipping museum at the start of last year's competition. And we've also seen a win a green street promotion. And if you could muster up your whole street that they wanted the street to be green, you could win a really cool green caravan, which made your helped you green the street, and you received plants and stuff and help to green the street. And as I said, we also encourage municipalities to contribute so they green the public spaces as well. And that's of course really necessary because the private gardens are a small part of it. But of course, bigger places mean more climate adaptation. So as I said, it would be nice to have a European championship. We already exported the concept to Flanders. So they've done it for 2 years now, and they have lifted 5 million tiles in total now. So that's really cool as well. That's also around, I'm not sure, around 100 football fields or something. And as we always say, flipping is more important than winning. In Dutch, it's nicer. It's vipping is more important than winning. Yeah, of course, it's 7 months of whipping, but we encourage people to lift tiles year round, because you can do that always, of course. And together we make the Netherlands and maybe the world, or at least Europe, a little bit more green. That was my story. I'm very curious if it was clear, and if you guys have any questions.
Wonderful, Eva, it was completely clear. thank you for all the insights.